Welcome to this special program in this Thanksgiving week. I remember in the past, you know, we used to collect testimonies and give thanks to the Lord. But this year, I'm just led to just sit here and talk to you about Thanksgiving itself and why you should give thanks. It's not a detailed study, it's an exhortation. And I want to give you one from 1 Chronicles chapter 16, verse 34. The Bible says, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good. For his mercy endureth forever. And say ye, save us, O God of our salvation, and gather us together, and deliver us from the heathen, that we may give thanks to thy holy name, and glory in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel forever and ever." And all the people said, "Amen," and praised the Lord. Oh, it's a hard thing. Thanksgiving is not an issue of words. It's a heart. The writer, the psalmist, the chronicles said, "Oh, give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good." Beloved, do you recognize the goodness of God in your life? Do you recognize how good God has been to you? Some of us only see problems. Some of us only see the pain. Someone said, you know, you do not only thank God for what he has done. You need to thank him for the things he did you didn't even know he did. He prevented the accident you didn't know about. He kept you from disease you didn't know about, from poison, from demonic influences and attacks in your life. God has done so much. Listen, when people do good things, we say they are good. Then tomorrow they do something wrong, then we say they are bad. But we are commanded to give thanks to the Lord because the Lord is good. There is no unrighteousness in God. Thanksgiving is praising the character and the nature of God. He is good. Don't allow anything to be injected into your life. Sometimes you're sick, you're believing for healing, and you're in pain, and you wonder, why doesn't God do something? I cannot answer all those questions, but I'm telling you, believe that the Lord is good, and your faith will bring you to your breakthrough. I want you to pay attention to the next segment of that scripture. It says, "For his mercy endureth forever." Wow. That means that the mercy of God has put up with so much for you to live as long as you have lived. The mercy of God has put up with so much for you to still make it, for you to have the prosperity you have, the blessings you have. The mercy of God has covered so much for you, forgiven you so much, delivered you from so much. Have you forgotten? Do you know that we are so prone to remember the negative things that happen to us, but we forget the wonderful things the Lord has done? Do you recognize how many wonderful things the Lord has done in your life? His mercy endureth. Endurance is putting up with things. His mercy kept putting up with your errors, your mistakes, your sins, your failures, your shenanigans, your stubbornness. Some of us are arrogance. Some of us are foolishness, downright foolishness. I mean, his mercy has endured. God never changed his mind. Wow. Beloved, Thanksgiving is such a powerful force. I know that I will eventually get to the popular scriptures in Psalm 100 and all of that, but do you recognize the mercy of the Lord in your life? If you haven't, then you are missing your greatest blessing. Listen to it. He says, and once the psalmist or the chroniclist said this, he said, and say ye, the moment you give the Lord a heartfelt thanks, the door for prayer and intercession opens, and you can make declarations of faith and miracles happen. He says, say ye, save us, O God of our salvation. And watch this, and gather us together and deliver us from the heathen. Why? What's the purpose for God's deliverance, God's blessing and prosperity? Not so we can receive and then indulge in our pleasures as the people did in the wilderness and offended God. He says, no, gather us, Lord, that we may give thanks to thy holy name and glory in thy praise. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel forever and ever. And all the people said, amen. May God gather you in your congregation. May God gather you in your family. May God gather you so that you may give thanks to the Lord and praise his name. For his name is holy. He's righteous in all his ways. Beloved, you will see miracles this Thanksgiving season. May the Lord bless you. We love you. We will continue to share this truth with you all week long. Amen and amen. That's what Jesus. Bye-bye.